Here's the regulator. When you buy a regulator, make sure you buy one that has the proper fitting for your bottle. This is, I believe it's called the CGA 580. I like it because it's got the scales on there, and it's also got whatever your input pressure is. So my only concern is after I put it on, I'm going to have to go ahead and use some bubble water everywhere on all the connections and make sure everything is tight and then that they don't leak. So let's go ahead and get everything mounted up, and then we'll do the bubble test, and I'll show that to you. Well, we had this hose on here, and it's just a press-on with like some serrated nipples on this thing, and it was too loose. You could just move it side to side and back out a little bit, and I knew it was going to leak. So Harbor Freight came with this little clamp on it just like that, and it was pretty inefficient. And so what I did is I went down to the auto parts store, and I bought some number 4 clamps. I just wanted to make sure that I didn't have any leaks here. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and mount the bottle on this thing and get the regulator on it. Well, I've got it all together. Got the C25 on it. The last thing I need to do is go ahead and do the leak check on this and make sure all the hoses don't leak anymore. And what we're going to use for that is we're going to use some soap and water. We'll spray on it. It also has a connector on the inside here, and I didn't bother to check that before I put the cover back on it. So I'm going to pull the cover back off the welder here, and then I'm going to energize the whole system, and then we'll do a leak check on it. To mount it, as you saw previously, I clamped this down, and then I went and clamped this one on here. Now this one was the actual fitting was larger than the one that was on the back of the welder over there. So what I ended up doing was I actually took like a candle lighter and I heated this up. Now this is non-flammable gas. Otherwise I wouldn't have done it. I would have probably taken it away or put the tank someplace else and then heated it up. But anyway, so I just heated this up with a lighter and then I squished this up on here and then I clamped it down. All right, I've got the cover off of it here. And by the way, for you guys that don't know how this works, you just push this in and you pull the tube out and it comes straight out. All right, let's go ahead and charge up this system here and see what the pressure is. So we got some pressure now. Let's get some soap here. I don't see anything. Well, actually, see them bubbles right there? That tells me the system is leaking. There we go. I've got a couple over there too. So we get here and check up in here. You know, let's give it a shot. Don't really see any there. Looks like my only leak is right there and right here. You know, and I tightened this thing down really tight too when I put it on there, but I guess it just didn't seal good enough. I can fix this one with some Teflon tape. I can't really fix this one Teflon tape because it's a CGA 580, and it's supposed to be a compression type fit. Maybe if I loosen it up and then retighten it, it'll solve that problem. I don't see any bubbles coming out, nothing. So I decided to go ahead and open the flow valve and see if there's any leaks. And I can't really see. It looks like there might be a little bit of one up in here. Can't really tell. I'll just let it sit for a little bit and see if bubbles come out. And I don't see any around this joint. I don't see any here. But I see a very active leak right here. So I'm going to have to, I'll probably just, since I'll never change that, I'll probably RTV it up or something. Here's our seal on the inside. I'm not too impressed with it. I think what I'm going to do is go ahead and Teflon it up. If that doesn't work, then I'll just epoxy it. And that should stop it from doing that. So as far as this side goes, I haven't taken it off yet. But I'll take it off and I'll have a good look on the inside. See what's up with that. I got about 3 or 4 layers of Teflon wrapped around this. And I'm going to pull this off and look inside, and then I'm going to screw this on and run another test on it and see how it goes. Okay, this is the inside of the bottle here, inside the throat. I don't see anything. It looks like it had a good seal, but I guess it wasn't good enough. Here's the end here. And it looks pretty good overall. It seems okay. I'll just clean it up real good, make sure there's no dust on it, and do it again. Maybe I'll have to compress it a few times to make sure everything forms really well. This is a brand new tank, by the way, and a brand new fitting on top, so maybe it just needs a little bit of working. And let's get this gauge back on. Had it on there for about 5 minutes now, and no bubbles either side, so I think I got these two fixed right here. So it looks like the only fix I have left to do is this one in here. Get this out of here. Push and pull, there it is.